purport by Srila Prabhupada ki jai. During the life of Swayambhuva Manu, six kinds of living entities were generated from the demigods known as the Tushitas, from the sages headed by Marichi and from descendants of Yajna, king of the demigods. And all of them expanded their progeny to observe the order of the Lord to fill the universe with living entities. The six kinds of living entities are known as Manus, Devas, Manuputras, Amshavataras, Sureshwaras, and Rishis. Yajna, being the incarnation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, became the leader of the demigods Indra. Hare Krishna. So yesterday, Maharaj had already elaborated and very beautifully described a lot of technical and intricacies of this material creation. So I'd just like to add a little further in what Prabhupada is explaining in today's purport. So we saw that how Yajna, who is actually the incarnation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he married Dakshina, who actually, even though materially speaking, appeared as sister of Yajna, but Prabhupada explains their transcendental relationship can never be changed. So just because materially speaking they would have appeared as brother and sister, but still their transcendental relationship never changes. So that is what it is said here. Then there were 12 boys who were born from Yajna and Dakshina. So they are named as Tosha, Paratosha, Santosha, like that it is described. And then all these sons collectively, they became the demigods called as Tushitas. Marichi took in charge as the head of the seven rishis, and Yajna himself became the king of heaven, Indra. He occupied the position of Indra. And through all these three different divisions, six varieties of living entities, six kinds of living entities were generated. So Prabhupada is saying here, during the life of Swayambhuva Manu, six kinds of living entities were generated from the demigods, known as Tushitas, from the sages headed by Marichi, and from descendants of Yajna, king of demigods. And then further, all of them expanded their progeny. And this is where Prabhupada gives a very important understanding. Why all of them are increasing this progeny? Why are they engaged in this work of increasing the population in this universe? All of them expanded their progeny to observe the order of the Lord to fill the universe with living entities. So actually it is the order of the Lord to fill the created universe with different varieties of living entities. And then these six kinds of living entities are Manus, Devas, Manuputras, Amsha Avataras, Sureshwaras, and Rishis. So, one important question comes up, that actually, why the Lord is ordering, we saw that earlier also, even to Brahma, this work of secondary creator was interested. Not only he should create the different planetary systems, he should fill this universe and the different planets with different kinds of living entities. So what is the mission of the Lord? There are two very important missions for which the Lord creates this material world. Anyone would like to help in understanding? What are the two missions for which the Lord creates this material world? Okay, very nice. So one is to unwillingly satisfy the desires of living entity to enjoy the material world. We should understand actually it is not that the Lord is willingly trying to create this material world. It's not that the government is very happy in making a prison house, isn't it? It's a big task to maintain the whole prison house. It's not a very good work. Nobody would like to do that. But it is required. So unwillingly, the Lord creates this material world to satisfy the desires of living entity to independently enjoy of the Lord. What is the second important mission? So even though the living entities have come to the material world to enjoy, to give them a chance to come out of this mentality, to improve this mentality and go back to their original nature of being the servant of the Lord, being dependent on the Lord and not independent of the Lord. So by the way of devotional service, to come out of this material world and go back to God. So actually, if you see this, it is because of these two important plans and missions of the Lord, there are two services which comes out of this mission of the Lord. Correct? One mission of the Lord is he wants to give a chance to the living entity unwillingly to come and try to satisfy their desire. So one service is now that, okay, those living entities who want to enjoy, they have to be populated here. So this is one of the mission of the Lord. This is one of the service which few devotees will have to carry out in this material world to increase the population in this world. These are these prajapatis who are carrying out this mission. There is another mission of the Lord which we saw is to relieve the living entity from this entanglement of this material world, to improve their mentality, to change their mentality from being independent to the devotional service of the Lord. And for that also, there are the devotees of the Lord who have to carry out this important aspect of the service also. Now actually, if you see, both of them is the service of the Lord. In this chapter, we will be seeing the first aspect of the service of the Lord to populate the universe with varieties of living entities and how the different progenies, how they procreated, how different kinds of living entities were produced in this material world. All that is described. Later, we will see. And actually the most important portion of Bhagavatam is the second aspect of the service of the Lord, to actually liberate the living entities from material entanglement. And we will also try to understand out of these two services, the second service of liberating the living entity from the entanglement of this material encagement is actually the most superior and very, very dear to the Lord. So this also we'll just try to understand in today's understanding. Earlier to this, in the third canto of Srimad-Bhagavatam, when Lord Brahma was entrusted with this matter of secondary creation and creating the different planetary systems and increasing the population in this universe, Brahmaji did not feel confident about himself. So it's a very important thing. Even though Brahma is the head of the universe, the topmost of all living entities in the universe, he felt himself inadequate to carry out this Herculean task. So what did Brahma do? In order to carry out his services very effectively, he prayed to the Lord. He offered some very important prayers, and Prabhupada explains this should be one of the very important principles of devotees who are entrusted with varieties of services to assist the mission of the Lord. They should be similarly offering prayers to the Lord like Brahma. Because this service of procreating and populating this universe, one has to come in touch with material energy. One has to come in touch with living entities who are in material consciousness. So material energy and living entities in material consciousness, when we associate, there is definitely we are prone to fall down while carrying out this kind of services. So Brahmaji made sure that even before I touch this kind of services, I pray to the Lord for protection. So this is very important. We should not be very confident. I want laptop, I want car, I want all these things. We should understand we are coming in touch with material energy. And then when we are going out and preaching to the people, we are coming in contact with people with material consciousness. And if we are not careful, if we are not sufficiently protected by the Lord, by the mercy of the Lord, there is very good chance of falling down. So this is very essential. And Prabhupada points out five very important aspects of Brahma's prayer. Before being engaged in this kind of services, where he is coming in touch with material energy of the Lord and material consciousness of living entity. Can anybody, if somebody remembers some of the point, we'll try to, I think that will be more better rather than. Anyone remembers some of the points? What are the different aspects of his prayers which Brahmaji is offering to the Lord? It's very interesting, very important. The very first point Brahmaji makes is that while I am engaged in this mission of yours of creating and populating this material universe, let me be fully Krishna conscious. Let me not be material conscious. I should be completely conscious of you while carrying out my duties. So exactly Prabhupada says, he says, only to engage in his service in the creation of material world, not in the service of Maya. I may be coming in touch with Maya, but I don't want to be engaged in the service of Maya. I want to engage Maya in the service of Krishna. So this is one very important prayer which Brahmaji is offering to the Lord. What is the second? Any other? Not to become victim of pride. Very nice. Because this kind of work, when we are coming in touch with material energy, the opulence of material energy, just like Brahmaji has to create this whole material universe, the different planetary system. And we know there will be people who will identify he is the creator. Right? So we may also come across such kind of different things. Now somebody is in collection service and we may be collecting and somebody say, Prabhuji, aapne hi to mandir banaya hai. Aapne itne saal pasina baha karke, so much you have slogged. And sometimes we also say, sometimes, right? We say, Prabhu, I slogged for so many years. Slogged for so many years. You know, that is how this temple is standing. So Brahmaji wanted to be very careful to understand. No pride should come while carrying out this kind of services. So what is actually the basis of no pride coming? Prabhupada says, Brahmaji wanted to remain in his real position, not false position. This is a false position. Pride comes because of false understanding. When we have a real understanding, humility will come, not pride. So what is the real understanding? Real understanding is I am just an instrument in the hand of the Lord. Everything is done by the Lord. I am just like a puppet. The Lord wants me to move like this, he moves like this. Not even a blade of grass moves without the sanction of the Lord. When one understands this, he can remain in his humble position. Then pride will not come. So this is the second very important aspect of prayers of Brahmaji. Third one, any other? One else? Okay. It is, I may not be in the course of doing my duty become materially affected. My consciousness should not become materially affected while handling material energy. So this is also very, very important that actually material energy is very strong. Krishna says that, mama maya durattaya. So there is no question of thinking that actually we can capture material energy of the Lord, because that is actually, after all, the energy of the Lord. Even though we are superior, no doubt about it, but we are very tiny. We cannot overcome this powerful energy of the Lord without getting the mercy of the Lord. Mameva prapadhyante maya metam tarantite. So he is praying to the Lord, while carrying out my duties, material duties, I should not become materially affected by that. Another is, he says, in the course of my material activities, I may not become deviated from spiritual energy to material energy. See? I may not become deviated from spiritual energy to material energy. That means mistaking. Sometimes that, let us say, for example, when we are carrying out our different duties, sometimes we become dependent on material facilities, not understanding if these are present, I am utilizing. Not that these are necessary and only with these things I can carry out the services of the Lord. That is not the idea. When the Pandavas were in the kingdom, they utilized the whole kingdom in the service of the Lord. When they were out of kingdom, they never thought that now we are bereft of everything, we cannot serve the Lord. So even when they were in the forest, they were completely dependent on the Lord. They were not dependent on material facilities to serve the Lord. When it is present, they were utilizing. So Brahmaji is praying, in the course of my activities, which I am going to carry out, I should not become diverted from spiritual energy. I am trying that I should be Krishna conscious while doing all these activities. I should not become diverted to material energy, because there is a very good chance to become diverted. Okay, only four of them. I thought there were five. Four I could understand. Then, in the purport to These prayers, Prabhupada very nicely enlightens some very interesting aspects of the prayers of Brahmaji. One of them we discussed already. Brahmaji wanted to remain in his original position as instrument of the Lord. That is why he is offering this prayer. And Prabhupada says, this is a way of becoming very dear to the Lord and obtain the mercy of the Lord. If we want to become dear to the Lord and if we want to receive the mercy of the Lord, then we should be like in the position of Brahmaji, who wants to become just an instrument in the hand of the Lord while carrying out his different duties. Then, second very important point which Prabhupada points out from these prayers is, it's very interesting, all of us should make note of this. Prabhupada is saying, every person engaged in transcendental loving service in material world, in spiritual world it is different. When we are engaged in the spiritual world, there is no Maya. But when we are engaged in transcendental loving service of the Lord, in the material world, everyone should understand that in material world, he is prone to so many material activities. This material world is meant for that. Our consciousness is prone to do material activities. And if one is not strong enough to protect himself from material affection, he may be diverted from spiritual energy. So first thing we have to realize is we are very prone in the material world because this is a kingdom of Maya. In this kingdom of Maya, we are trying to render transcendental service to the Lord. So there is very good possibility we are prone that we will become diverted. And until and unless we have sufficient strength to protect ourselves, then definitely we may be diverted from spiritual energy to material energy. So then what is that strength? How do we obtain that strength? So that also Prabhupada explains. This is a warning for one and all in the spiritual advancement of life. So this is not just warning for Brahmaji. This is warning for one and all who wants to advance in spiritual life. Unless one is sufficiently protected by the Lord, he may fall down from his spiritual position. Unless one is sufficiently protected by the Lord, one may fall down from his spiritual position. So what should be done? So therefore, Prabhupada is saying, therefore, one has to pray constantly to the Lord for protection and blessings to carry out one's duties. One is always pray to the Lord for protection and always pray to the Lord for his blessings so that one can carry out one's duty in Krishna consciousness. So this is what we can see, a very important aspect of this service when we are engaged in our devotional service. After hearing the prayers of Brahmaji, the Lord was very satisfied. And the Lord replied to him. So very interesting, that is also how the Lord replies to Brahmaji's prayer. So the Lord says, Nana karma vitanena. My dear Brahma, you are engaged, you want to be engaged in varieties of services. And we'll see Prabhupada explains that actually this is how the spiritual master engages the disciple in varieties of services of the Lord. Different varieties of services to accomplish the mission of the Lord. We will see what is that variety of service Krishna is talking about. Nana karma vitanena. Vitanena means expansion. You want to expand your services by different varieties. How is that? Prajaha bahavi sishikshataha. You have a desire to sishikshataha means to increase praja by innumerable. Innumerably you want to populate this universe as per my desire. And you are planning varieties of services in that direction to expand this desire. So then what is the Lord saying? The Lord is saying, do not worry, you will be protected. So what does he say? Na atma avasidati asminte. You will never be bereaved even though you are engaged in material service. So called. Externally you are touching material objects and you are creating material world. Do not worry, you will never come under bereavement. You will not have any shortfall in that direction. And then, Varshiyan mad anugraha. You will be able to expand your services because of my mercy. So I will just read the translation Prabhupada says. Since you have desired to increase the population innumerably and expand your varieties of services, you shall never be deprived in this matter because my causeless mercy upon you will always increase for all times. So if we are actually engaged, similarly Prabhupada and similarly Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives us this assurance that if we are engaged in the service of the Lord, in the mission of the Lord, and while being engaged in the mission of the Lord, we may also have to come in touch with different varieties of services in material domain, looking like in material domain. We have to do some management, we have to go and do some kind of selling, we may have to imbibe some kind of skills, all these kinds of things. But Prabhupada gives an assurance that as long as we are trying to sincerely carry out, engage all these things in the service of the Lord, we will be protected. Just like the Supreme Lord is giving assurance to Brahma because he is doing all this sincerely in the service of the Lord. So similarly, we will be protected. So I just remembered reading through one very interesting conversation with Prabhupada with some of his disciples. Because actually we can see nana karma vitanena, varieties of services we should become engaged in. And the Lord is very happy. He wants to expand and increase his services in that direction to accomplish the mission of the Lord. So there is a very interesting conversation. What happened was that one devotee was engaged in one of the temple and he was carrying out very nice services. But what happened, because of whatever reason, the devotee had to be transferred from there to some other place. So Tamal Krishna is asking, Prabhupada, this devotee is leaving. He has to transfer his service to someone. So he's leaving to some other place. Now he'll have to transfer his service. We find, sometime we have to go and hand over our services to somebody else. Prabhupada is replying, Sevon mukhe hi jivahado swayam eva hi spuruti adaha. Prabhupada explains the importance of service. Prabhupada is saying, this service is the only means to understand Krishna. There is no other mean to understand Krishna. Krishna cannot be understood. But sevon mukhe hi jivahado. Service is so important, this service attitude is so important. Swayam eva hi spuruti adaha. Beginning with tongue, when we start serving the Supreme Lord, then automatically the Supreme Lord will reveal himself. So Prabhupada is saying, We should not transfer our service to somebody. Something is entrusted. Of course, when it is authorizedly transferred, it is different. Somebody wants to give up his service and say, no, Prabhu, enough of this. I want to peacefully go and chant somewhere. What is this? So, you know, I have to struggle here and build this temple. I have already done a lot of, you know, all these things. So that is what was happening in this case. Not that the authorities were transferring him. He wanted to go away leaving his services. So Prabhupada is saying, we should not transfer our service to somebody. And then Prabhupada says a very important principle. The more we serve, the more we understand Krishna. Actually, that should be our idea. The more we serve, the more we will be able to understand Krishna. The only means of understanding Krishna is service. There is no other mean. This is the only mean. Then one devotee is trying to counter that, and he is giving his idea of vision. He is saying, no, someday one person will do the floor. Let us say it is floor cleaning. One person will do the floor. Next day another. I was thinking everybody could have an opportunity that way. So another devotee is thinking that, you know, it's a good opportunity. Okay, you remove him, you put somebody else will have an opportunity. So Prabhupada is very, he has a very insight actually in all these understandings. He's segregating both. He's saying, this mentality of opportunity is good. You are saying we'll have an opportunity. But to neglect the opportunity, that is not good. So Prabhupada says, the attitude, here is an opportunity, that is very nice. But sometimes we try to transfer this opportunity. How? Being compassionate with others. Very compassionate. Prabhu, I have done a lot of service. Now I am very compassionate. Now you should do. Isn't it? Prabhupada is saying that actually. But sometimes being compassionate, we want to transfer this service to other. And Prabhupada is saying, Karunika. Why? Devotees are very compassionate. Isn't it? We want to transfer our service. Why? We are very compassionate. And then Prabhupada is very nicely saying, please, you take this service and other services. I may just take prasadam. That I can't neglect. You see? So, this attitude is different. Isn't it? So, Prabhupada is actually very nicely explaining about the importance of different services. Nana karma vithanena, how one should be engaged in different varieties of services to accomplish the mission of the Lord. And then further Prabhupada says, of course, Krishna is very kind. Even though you dump your service on somebody else and you take to just prasadam eating also, what to do? Krishna is still very kind. And Krishna is so kind, any service you do, still Krishna accepts. So, this is what we can understand from this whole episode of Brahmaji trying to serve the Supreme Lord, trying to accomplish that mission of the Supreme Lord as a secondary creator, as an instrument in the hand of the Lord to populate this material universe with population, varieties of living entities. This, as we said, is the first part. Now then comes the second part. Living entities have come into the material world. And now the second part begins. It's the work of very, very dear servants of the Lord, confidential servants of the Lord. Because we see the work of populating is given even to a materialistic person like Daksha. But the work of extricating the living entity from this world and sending them back to Godhead, that is given only to very confidential devotees. And Krishna says that in Bhagavad Gita, anyone who is actually giving this message of Bhagavad Gita, this message which Krishna has spoken to Arjuna in the battlefield. He is the most dear of all living entities. Even though Krishna is impartial, he is not partial. But anyone who spreads this message of the Lord, Sarva Dharman Parityajya, that everybody should give up their different varieties of so-called manufactured religion, simply surrender to the Lord and go back to Godhead. So this message, if somebody is preaching, he is very, very dear to the Lord. That example also we come across in Bhagavatam. We see Brahma in the course of his creation, when he wanted procreation, he ordered Lord Shiva, you go and procreate. He ordered Daksha, you go and procreate. Similarly, he ordered four Kumaras, you go and procreate. But we find the four Kumaras were liberated right from their birth. They never wanted to be engaged in this kind of services. So they rejected the offer of the father that you first, go into this, go into a materialistic, in this married life, procreate children. They wanted to set a very important example that if it is possible to avoid this whole humbug of getting into material entanglement, it is far better. So they rejected this offer of their father. And actually we see because of that, Brahma became very angry. And because of his anger, Rudra came out. And because he was in that angry moment, he came out. And then when he ordered Shiva, Rudra, that now you go and procreate, he started procreating and he started filling the universe with all kind of abominable living entities, ghosts and all these things. Then he said, your service is not required at the present moment. When your service is required, I'll call you back. Your service will be required when we have to annihilate. Isn't it? So, Brahma, when he was engaged in his work, and Kumaras, they were engaged in another work, we find. And Prabhupada explains that actually the work of Kumaras, in that, because they were carrying out a superior service to the Lord, they could neglect the order of their father. It is only on this principle, because they were carrying out the superior order of the Lord. So as we saw, there are two kinds of services. One is to procreate and fulfill the desire of the living entity. That is also mission of the Lord, because he wants to satisfy the desires of living entity. That is one. But actually nobody is happy in that direction. Nobody will be happy that we have to fill up all these prison houses. And we find Daksha became angry. Actually it is not proper. Isn't it? Later on, when Daksha was asked to procreate, first he produced 10,000 children. And generally, the first they have to be spiritually trained. Before they procreate, they have to be spiritually trained. So they went and they were, they were performing a lot of austerities, they were getting purified. Narada saw that actually this is a very good position they are in. They are already performing a lot of austerities, they are getting purified. Why they should enter into family life? This is a chance for them that they can actually directly surrender to the Lord and come out of this material entanglement. So he preached to them, and those sons of Daksha, they said to father, no, we cannot follow your order. We want to become liberated from this material world. So they followed the orders of Narada. First time this happened. Still Daksha was patient. Okay, no problem. I'll create another 10,000. So another 10,000 children he produced. And again sent them. Prabhupada says, even knowing that Narada has already, liberated his 10,000 children, and they did not follow the order of his father, in spite of that he sent, because Daksha, at least he knew religious principles. Just because Narada went and preached there does not mean they should not undergo austerity. That is not his idea. Still he sent. No problem, I will still send. And next 10,000 children, when again in the same way, they were preached that your 10,000 elder brother, they are already liberated. Why you want to become entangled? You should also follow their footsteps. So they also followed the footsteps. So they also followed what Narada had to say. Then Daksha became very angry. He came and he cursed Narada Muni. He said, you have destroyed whole material life. I give you this curse. You will never be able to stay in one place. And Prabhupada says, from that time, Narada Muni is very happy. Going around, not staying in one place, simply going and preaching the mission of the Lord. Prabhupada is saying, like Daksha, somehow I have also been cursed by the fathers of these children whom I have engaged in the superior service of the Lord. They have also cursed me. But in one way, Prabhupada is saying, even though I have 108 temples, but I am not able to stay in any one of these temples. I am simply traveling like Narada Muni and preaching this Krishna consciousness. So we find in Bhagavatam both these aspects of services of the Lord. And as Prabhupada is very nicely explaining here, we can see that they try to increase the population in this material world on behalf of the Lord, to observe the order of the Lord, that they have to populate this material universe. We'll stop with this. If anyone has any question, maybe one.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Personalities like Lord Brahma or Lord Shiva, even though they are engaged in service with this material world, they never get entangled because of Lord's mercy. But there are some incidences in Bhagavatam, in Vedas, it appears like they have done some abominable mistake. So why is it so? Is it to teach a lesson to humanity? Or?
Yes, that is the most important thing. Even when Brahmaji was bewildered, Brahma himself was bewildered, or when Shiva was bewildered by Mohini Murti, it is all to set some very important principles that material energy is very strong. Even though one may be very highly spiritually elevated, he may still come under the snare of material. So always we should be under the protection of the Lord. That is the lesson one should learn. Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. As we see, like in our material world, when government is constructing the prison house, so it is still in this material world only. So why Lord has chosen a different world to create this prison house? So can't it be in the same spiritual world so that they can at least see the world and they can get inspired?
Okay, very good. Actually, in real sense, there is no such differentiation. It is a part of spiritual world, but a corner of the spiritual world. Prabhupada gives an example, just like there is a vast sky. In that sky itself is that cloud. Cloud is not some separate creation somewhere else. It is a part of that. But it's a very minor, very small creation. So cloud, that eternal sky, is like the spiritual world, and the cloud is like the material world. Just like the sky always remains, cloud does not remain always. Sometime it is manifest, sometime it is not manifest. So according to the desires of the living entity, it becomes manifested. And then again it becomes rolled back. And again it becomes manifested. So like that it is going on. Isn't it? Like even in the material world, when Prabhupada was, even though he was giving classes in America, Prabhupada said it is a matter of consciousness. If our consciousness is in Krishna, then that is not a part of material world. That is also spiritual world. So Prabhupada is saying, I am still in Vrindavan, even though I may be sitting in America. This is Vrindavan. Because that consciousness of Vrindavan is what is important. The Prabhupada gave the example, what is the difference between this temple and the outside building? Matter is the same. But the consciousness for what it is utilized, everything here is utilized in the service of the Lord. That is the difference. Stop with this. Grantra Srimad Bhagavatam ki Srila Prabhupada ki jai.